I made a resin rainbow cuff bracelet. You can too. And you can adjust the sizing to fit any wrist. Hi, this is Fran with littlewindows.com. And here's what you'll need to make them. Double-sided molds. I'll be using the oval shape and the bangle bracelet side for this project. I'll also be using a new tool, mold dividers, that are designed to fit in the Little Windows molds. Each set includes four dividers made of a soft, flexible silicone. They're perfectly shaped to fit these molds, creating smooth, shiny ends. To make this cuff bracelet with six colors of resin, I need seven dividers total. The two-pack set comes with eight. And I'll be using Brilliant Resin, which comes with reusable measuring cups and mixing wands. It comes in sizes from a small sample set up to gallons, so you can pick just what you need for your project. I'll use alcohol inks to color my resin, this rainbow color set, and a bottle of rainbow sparkle, which adds super fine glittery particles that stay suspended in this resin. If you have a large silicone doming tray, you may want to use it, but it's not mandatory for this project. Each pack comes with a guide showing some of the amazing things you can create, including cuff bracelets, color blocks like these mini dioramas from my last video, and teardrop castings you can make using the handles. I'd love it if you subscribe to my channel and click the bell so you'll know right away when I have a new idea for you. You will need a protective dust cover. I'm using a creation station to protect my projects while they set up. These have been a game changer in organizing my workspace, and after my resin has thickened a bit, I can move this creation station and even stack them to free up my tabletop. If you're only making one or two projects, you can use the clear dust covers that come with these molds. You'll find all of these supplies at littlewindows.com. Follow the link above or the links in the description below. Open the side of your mold and push the divider down against the bottom, making sure it's standing up straight. I'll start by placing the two dividers that are going to form the opening for my cuff bracelet. The spacing between them should match the thickness of your wrist. Cuffs typically have a tighter fit than bangle bracelets, so I will space my dividers to create a wider opening, and then I'll close that gap later to make the whole bracelet smaller, and it'll fit me just right. I'm going to use six colors, so I'll need to place five more dividers evenly spaced around the mold. I've got my Brilliant Resin ready to go. I just love this stuff. It's not only the safest epoxy you'll find, it's super versatile too. As always, be sure your surface is level before pouring resin or it'll cure crooked. In the double-sided mold guide, you'll see each oval bangle mold takes about 30 milliliters to fill. I've made sure my part A is nice and warm so it blends easily. I want to make six colors of resin to pour together, so I'll make a 45 milliliter batch total and use any leftovers in other projects. Blend this for 2.5 minutes, then let your mix rest in the cup for 5 minutes so that it can blend more thoroughly and any bubbles can rise and pop. I'll add a couple of drops of my rainbow sparkle to the whole batch and then divide that into six cups to make the different colors. I'll be coloring my casting with alcohol inks to get juicy, transparent color. Alcohol inks can fade over time, so be sure you saturate these with 10 to 15 drops of each color. Pour one color into each section, filling to the top. The sticky tab reminds me which section will be my cuff opening, so I remember to leave that part empty. Let the resin settle for 10 to 15 minutes, then hold your mold down while you pull out the dividers between colors, leaving the two at the ends. Since I'm using my creation station, I can just place the dividers with wet resin on them on the base surface, and it'll peel off pretty easily once my resin has set up. If you don't have one of these handy workstations, you can use the back of your large silicone doming tray or a piece of wax paper. Since the dividers pulled some resin out with them, my fill level is low, so I'll come back in and add a bit more of each color. Then let that set up. This is ready to demold. Because I use the dividers, my colors haven't merged or blended too much, but instead of lines straight up and down, the colors have formed angled shapes. I get random effects each time. I think it mostly has to do with the way you pull the dividers out. Loosen the side of the mold all the way around. To keep these bits and pieces from falling into your mold, it's best to remove them before you take your casting out. These molds are so highly polished, the castings come out super shiny. I'll remove the first divider. I didn't use the blue band that came with these dividers, which would have prevented or at least minimized this leakage. But it's okay. It's a very thin amount, so all you have to do is bend the flap back and forth and it'll come right off. I'll do the same with the other divider. Clean that up and the ends will be nice and smooth. These dividers are highly polished, so your ends are going to be smooth and shiny and comfortable. The first day after casting, you'll be able to change the size of your bangle. You can stretch it to make it bigger or compress it to make it smaller. If you want to make it smaller, I suggest the No Residue Resin Backer film. It's super shiny and leaves absolutely no residue. Pinch the bangle to the size you want and add a piece of the film to hold it in place. Let that set up for one more day and it'll be ready to wear. I didn't fill my mold all the way to the top, so you'll see there's a little bit of a dip. I've mixed up a tiny batch of resin, and I'll use my mixing wand to apply it just around the top. Let that resin set up and it'll be ready to wear. Now this is smooth and shiny all the way around. And it's fully hardened, so I can remove the backer film, and it fits me perfectly. If you want to make your bracelet bigger, you'll need to pull it open to the size you want, then prop it in place for one more day. I had some colored resin left over, so I cast some pieces in my silicone cabochons mold. I also added a couple more drops of each color to the handles of my dividers, and I'll use these little pretties in another project. Check out my other videos that use these dividers in different ways. I'd love it if you subscribe to my channel, click the bell, and you'll know as soon as I launch a new tutorial. Thanks for watching.